Hey guys, what's up? My name is Dave McKenzie. Welcome back to our channel. If you're new here, please hit the subscribe button and like the video and definitely leave a comment below. Those three things help us a lot. Today I'm going to be teaching you how to play Norwegian Wood by the Beatles. It's a killer tune to play as just an independent song. It's a great one to learn and I hope you really enjoy it. All right, see you on the other side of the video. Peace out. So I'm going to play through the tune and then I'll teach you how to play it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's how you play Norwegian Wood. So what you're doing is there's a few chords that you're going to need to know for this song. So the first chord is a D major chord shape with the capo on fret 2. That makes your D string an E string. So this is actually an E chord. But for the purposes of this video, we're going to call this chord D. So the first chord is D. Goes to this C add 9 and then it falls back to here, which is really a G chord, right? But with a B on the bass, and then open A and then back to the D. So there's a little melody. You should learn the melody. So the first part of the melody is this note here. It's played while you're holding the D chord down. So you play this note. And then you're going to reach up to the 4th fret, and then you're going to go back to this note, and then open, and then 4th on the D string. Now you're going to play the 2nd fret on the D string, and then the open G, and then the 4th on the D string, and then open D. And then you're going to play your little descending line here, which is 3rd fret. 3rd fret and then open D, and then 2nd fret, and then open A. So the melody again goes. And then it goes again. That melody, that's probably a really good place to start. Once you can play the melody, you're going to have to learn how to do the picking of that melody, where you play the tune and you answer it with the down up strum. So I play this first note, right? And then you play the second part of the melody. And then you play this and you hold it. So what I'm doing is I'm playing the fourth fret of the D string with my pinky while my D chord is down. This is the hardest part of the whole song, is to voice that chord. So try to get up on your fingertips and relax your hand and try not to work too hard for you. Try to sort of relax to get this. And then you're gonna do this riff here. And then open D. And then you're gonna go to the C add 9. And then back D, to D. And then it repeats, right? And that's how you do the verses. And the music breaks are the same. Now for the chorus, it's pretty simple. It's a D minor chord, and you play the root note D. And then you go to your G chord, play it like this with these three fingers so that you can go. So all I'm adding, that's a really nice folk music trick. It's been used by Bob Dylan a lot, who I would imagine the Beatles would have been listening to quite a bit when they were learning this tune or writing this song. They would have been pretty in touch with what Bob Dylan and Joni Mitchell and Neil Young were doing. So what you're doing is you're playing your G chord with these two fingers, and then you're putting this down, which sort of adds a C chord to the G chord. So it's D string 2nd fret, B string 1st fret. You can hammer it. To the D minor chord. So what I'm doing there is I'm alternating on the bass notes. I'm hitting the D string open. I'm doing a down, up after I hit the D string. And then I hit the A string. And then I repeat again, D, A. Now the next part of the chorus is a little different. Keep your pinky down here. And then you go to your E minor shape, which makes an E minor 7. Now leave your pinky there, put your first finger on the D string, 2nd fret, and this will make an A7 sus chord. And then you play that once, and then you drop your pinky note back to your 2nd finger playing the B string on the 2nd fret. And that's the whole chorus. Now we're back to the verse. And then we have a break. So the structure to this tune is there's an intro part, right? So you play the whole melody. And then it repeats. That's the intro. Then there's verse 1, and it's just like the intro. It plays the melody, and then it plays the melody again. And then for the chorus, well, you've learned the chorus. It's D minor to the G, and then D minor to the E minor 7, to the A 7 sus, to the A 7. And then we have another verse, so that's verse 2, and then that verse 2 is repeated, right? And then there's a break, and the break works just like the intro. It's once through, and then there's a repeat. Then we have the chorus 2, so it's the 2nd chorus. Then we have verse 3, and there's a repeat there. It's just like all the other verses. And then the outro just goes once. That's the structure. Hopefully that was easy enough to follow. I can sort of scratch that out in the description for you. So I really hope that you guys take the time to learn this song. Don't give up on it. Break it down into manageable parts. Learn all your chords. Learn the riffs. Right, and then add it to the chords with the down-up strumming. Hey everybody, I hope you enjoyed that video. We love making them for you, so once again, subscribe to the channel, hit the like button on the videos, and definitely leave your comments below. We'll teach you all sorts of songs that you want to learn, and then stay tuned for more videos. Peace out.